Hi folks, Glyn here with a new episode for you, episode 91, real quick one. I want to show you how you can make a window frame type of shadow in your pictures. So here you see before, after, before, after. Okay, so before we get started then, on screen you can see the final retouch picture. I'm going to be doing a tutorial taking you through all the retouching steps to get to this final image here. But just so you know, the actual starting point, this is kind of like the raw file where nothing has been done to it in Camera Raw or Lightroom. This is the out of camera shot. So I'm going to show you how you can take this picture all the way through to this picture here. But for today, what I thought I'd do is just show you one small part of that retouching, and that's the actual window frame type of shadow that you can see just a little bit on the background behind our subject here. Now, just on the point about this background here, you'll notice, before we dive over to do the technique, the background here, I'm using a gray. Now, that's great for doing the compositing. We can use blend modes to add textures and backgrounds. But what you'll notice is that the background in the actual out of camera shot isn't evenly lit. Now, that's intentional, because what we don't want to do is have a background that is just pure gray going across there, no shadows, nothing, because that'll be really, really boring. When I'm doing this kind of stuff and I am actually using a grey background behind a model, I will purposely have a little bit of shadow detail actually hitting onto that background, because it just makes it a little bit more interesting. But let's just dive on and just quickly show you this, how to create this window frame type of effect here. You can see the effect behind our model here, and it's come up to the layers panel over on the right hand side. It's the uppermost layer. I'll just turn that on and off. You can see that it's very subtle, but it does add a bit more interest to it. So here's how we're going to do it. Let's just delete that layer there. I'm just going to press D on my keyboard to get my foreground and background colors to their default of black and white, and you can see that now over in the toolbar. Then I'm going to add a new blank layer to the top of the layer stack, and just so we know what's what, we'll just rename that one to Window. Then I'm going to come to the toolbar and I'm going to select the Custom Shape tool. Now that's down about three quarters of the way down the toolbar there. You can see we've got a rectangle tool, ellipse tool, polygon, but right at the bottom, custom shape tool. So when I click on that, in the options bar at the top of the screen, we've now got this little area called shape with a drop down menu. And these are loads and loads of different shapes that are in Photoshop by default that you can make use of for all manner of things. But the one we're going to be using is the 3x3 grid, which you can see just around about here. So let's just click on that to activate it. I'll click on the top bar to remove that, that list of shapes there. And I'm going to click in the top left of the picture and drag outwards. And you can see as I do that, we do get this 3x3 grid. But as I move around, the height and the width of it vary. I want this to be kind of even on the height and the width. So to do that, just hold down my shift key as I drag outwards. So we'll get it to around about, let's move the space bar to move it, somewhere around about there will be fine. So you can see now we've kind of got our 3x3 window frame, but it's actually quite thin and there is nowhere at the top that we can increase the actual width of all these different sections here. So all I'm going to do is press Command or Control J on my keyboard to create a copy of it. And you'll see now over in the layers panel, we've now got window copy there. Then I'm going to go to my move tool and I'm just going to use my right arrow key. I'm going to click across a few times, 3, 4, to increase the width. And then we'll crease up a few clicks, maybe 3 or 4 clicks to increase that just a little bit more. So you can see now by just moving that 3x3 grid, we've made it look a little bit wider, but I want it even wider still. So I think I'll create another copy. So Command or Control J, again, press down my move tool and then use the right and left arrow keys to go either left or right a few clicks, and then the up arrow key just to make it a little bit thicker there. So now we've got quite a nice big thick grid. I don't need all those three layers, so with the top one selected, I'll hold down the shift key, click on the first window frame there so they're all highlighted, and then go to the flyout menu at the top right of the layers panel and just click on merge layers. So that now becomes one layer. Now I'm actually going to blur this so that I don't have to kind of like do a blur, get it wrong, redo it. Obviously we're going to be using smart filters. So with this window layer here, I then go to the filter menu at the top of the screen, choose convert for smart filters. So we get that smart object, smart filter icon in the bottom right hand corner of the thumbnail there over in the layers panel. And then all I'm simply going to do is go to the filter menu, choose blur, and we'll just use Gaussian blur. And we can kind of dial in now how much blur we want for that window window frame to have. And I want this one to be really quite subtle, so I'm gonna take it up quite a significant amount, around about 150-ish, something like that. Yeah, that should do. Obviously then we'll just click OK. And obviously being a smart filter, if I wanted to change that, I'd just double click on the actual filter name there to bring up the Gaussian blur dialog box, but I'm quite happy with around about 150, 153. Now, if you turn that on and off, we can see that obviously, because this is at the top of the layer stack, it's going to be on top of our model and our subject. So quite simply, all we do, come to the bottom of the layers panel, add a layer mask. It's a white layer mask, meaning we can see everything. So to hide parts of it, i.e. the parts going over our subject, I'm just going to get a straightforward brush, nice simple round brush. Let's just make sure there's no silly settings in there that'll make it behave a bit funny. And making sure I've got a black foreground color. So now all I need to do is just paint it off the actual subject here. So let's just paint it off his leg, a bit off the chair, came down quite low on that one. Something like that. So now we can turn it on and off. And then all we do is just lower the opacity maybe just a little bit. And actually at the bottom, if you look as I turn it on and off, look at the frame here, the window frame, it's quite an obvious line going across the bottom there. So then all I would simply do is get the brush, making sure that it's 0% hardness, and I'll just make it nice and big and just add a couple of strokes just to soften it and blend it in just a bit on the bottom there. So we can turn it on, off, on, off. A real simple effect, but it does add a little more interest onto that background to give it a little bit more kind of atmosphere. So that's all for now. Before I go, just one quick thing. If you haven't already, obviously make sure that you sign up to this YouTube channel. It's great to know that you folks are out there and supporting it just by clicking on the subscribe button, which is free. But one other little thing that's free for you, if you go to my website, glynjewish.com, over on the right-hand side here where you've got your email address, if you put your email address in there and just click on send, you'll then get a link to download something that we're producing every single month, which are these free tip sheets, like a PDF download that you can get hold of. And we're also going to be producing a PDF on the power of P, which is a few steps which can guarantee to show you how you can get a successful photo shoot every single time. We're going to have like a downloadable PDF there for you. But that's enough of my voice. Thanks for tuning in, and I'll see you next time.